Okay, so first of all, what I'm going to start with, I'm going to start with JavaScript. When we are talking about the JavaScript, the first thing, what exactly the JavaScript is, it's a kind of a scripting language. It's a kind of a scripting language. Normally, we use a scripting language. Normally, we use a scripting language to add functionality with HTML tags and other programming stuff. JavaScript, it's a kind of a scripting language. The first thing that we need to focus on, a scripting language. Normally, we have different types of programming languages are there, like C, C++, Java, C Sharp, Python. These are the normal programming languages. Here, what we are talking about? We are talking about the script JavaScript. JavaScript is what? It's a kind of a scripting language. Normally, we use a scripting language to add functionality with HTML tags and other programming stuff. Like, as for example, suppose we are having the button. We are having the HTML button. And what I'm looking for, if I am going to click on this button, I should display some message. What I need to do, I just need to display some message. This is the task that we need to do. We are having a button. Okay, we can create the button in HTML. But the question is, what I'm looking for, when I will click on the button, it should display some message. That's what I'm looking for. Suppose we are having a text box. We are having a text box. What I'm looking for, like in the text box, always you have to make some entry. And if I'm going to make it blank, there must be some error. Like some error message will be there. Like some error message will be there. If going to leave text box blank. Text box blank. So what I'm trying to say, if I need to add the events, if I need to do some events handling, event handling. Event handling means what? I'm going to click on the button. I'm going to double click on the button. It's event handling. So if I need to do some event handling, some validations. Validations means, suppose the text box is blank, there must be some message. If I'm going to give some number in the place of a string, there must be some message. If I'm going to give a string in the place of number, there must be some message. If I'm going to click on the submit button without entering the text in the value, like the forms controls, like text box and all, there must be some message. So if I need to put some validations, if I need to put some event handling, in that case, what we need to use, we need to use a scripting language. A scripting language. Because these things we can't do with the HTML. Normally I ask the question to the candidates, like we are having the HTML. HTML is, again, it's a kind of language. Even though it's a markup language, but again, it's a language. So HTML is always already we are having. Then what is the use of this JavaScript? So JavaScript is basically used for the event handling. If I want to put some events, if I want to put some validations, for that purpose, what we required? We require the scripting language. And one important thing I would like to mention over here, normally, in the broader sense means if I'm using JSP, if I'm using PHP, if I'm using Django, if I'm going to use the ASP.NET, in that particular case, normally, JavaScript is used for client-side programming. Client-side programming. Like if I'm going to write the JSP code, it's a server-side code. If I'm going to write the Django code, it's a server-side script. if I'm going to write the PHP code, it will be the server-side script. If I'm going to write the ASP.NET code, it's again the server-side script. So what I need to do, if I need to do the client-side programming, for that purpose, what exactly we required? We required some scripting language. So a scripting language is not a full-fledged language. It's not going to make any exe and all. A scripting language is what? It's normally used with the markup language or with the web technologies like JSP and all. So this is the answer. Normally, JavaScript is used for client-side programming. And for the client-side programming, it's not only the JavaScript that required, even though some other scripting languages are also there. Like we are having JavaScript. We are having the JScript. JScript and JavaScript both are the different thing. Like we are having the VBS script. Oh, VBS script is also there. Remember, this JavaScript, it's a product by Netscape. This JScript, it's a product by Microsoft. Like VBS script, it's again a product by Microsoft. So we are having multiple scripting languages are there. JavaScript, JScript, VBS script. But the most popular one is the JavaScript. We don't get confused. Remember, JavaScript and JScript both are the different thing. Don't make the full form. Okay, JScript, okay, JavaScript. It's not like that. JavaScript is the different stuff. JScript is the different stuff. And one important thing for your kind information, JavaScript has nothing to do with the Java. Yeah. Java is a big language. JavaScript is a small language in compared to Java. JavaScript is a small language. It's kind of a scripting language. Java is a high level language. It's a huge language. A lot of things are there in the Java. But JavaScript, it's a kind of a scripting language. It's not a normal language. So JavaScript has nothing to do with the Java. Don't get confused. Okay. So this is the first thing. What exactly the JavaScript is? What are the scripting languages available over there? Why we use JavaScript? This is the practical example. Why we need to use the JavaScript? Because in HTML itself, we can't do the programming for the buttons click and all. For the event handling, for the validations, we can't do that. For that purpose, normally we can go for the JavaScript. The other scripting languages are JavaScript, JScript, and VBS script. These are the other scripting languages. And one important thing, JavaScript has nothing to do with the Java. Now, I'm just going to make it comment. Okay, now I'm going to write the code. HTML, head, and this is the body I'm going to use. Remember, we can write the JavaScript code within the body or within the head. Like this is the body I'm going to use. Now, what I need to do, I need to use the scripting language. I'm just going to write a script. In the earlier browsers and all, normally a lot of things we need to write. But in today's scenario, all the modern browser, a script means if I'm going to write the script, all the modern browser is going to consider, okay, it's a JavaScript. So now I'm going to write this, like I'm going to do like document.write. And I'm going to write H1, thanks, Santos. Yeah, I'm just going to write like this. And I'm going to save this. Save as, I'm going to save on the desktop like a.html. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to run this. And we are getting the message, thanks, Santos. And this message is not coming from the HTML. This message is coming from the JavaScripts. So document.write is there. And just if I want to display something, I will go for the document.write. Now, what I need to do, and remember, here I am writing JavaScript within the body. if I need to display something, I will also go for the alert. Alert, thanks, and welcome. Run this, file save, and I'm going to run this. See what we are getting? We are getting the message, thanks and welcome. This is the alert message. This is the alert message with OK button. So this is what, this is the alert message. If I need for OK and cancel, like I'm going to use confirm. Like want to save. Run this. This is the alert. And this is the confirm. In the confirm, we are getting OK and cancel both. Two things are there. One is OK and one is cancel. And so alert, only OK is there. Confirm, there is the OK and cancel. Like we can also use prompt. Prompt, enter name. Run this. This is confirm. And this is the prompt. Going to ask you for the input. And suppose I'm going to give the name like a Smith. Now what I need to do, I want to save this particular, like what the value I'm going to enter over there, I want to save this, that particular value. So what I'm going to do, I'm just writing where nm is equal to. Var means variable. It's not necessary to use the var keyword over there. It's not required. I can simply go for the nm is equal to. But as a standard, I'm just going to use var nm is equal to. Now what I need to do, I need to display that. Alert, I'm writing the name is plus nm. Run this. I'm going to give the name like Rajesh. And we are getting the message, the name is Rajesh. So this is how you can display the dialogue. Alert is there. Confirm is there. For the input, we are having the prompt. If I want to store this value in the variable, we can go for like this. If I want to display the values, what we can go for, we can go for like this. So this is how we can write the JavaScript code. But normally, this is the bad practice. Normally, we should avoid to write the JavaScript within the body. So this is not the good practice. So I'm not going to use this. What I'm going to use, I'm just going to copy this. I'm just going to copy this. Control C. Better. I'm just going to create this different file over there. Save as b.html. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to make the copy of this. Now, within the head, I'm going to write a script. I'm just going to write a script. A script. And going to close this script. And I'm going to create a function. Like function A. This is the function. And within this function, I'm going to put all these code like document.write, confirm, where, everything is there. So this is the function we are having. This is the function we are having. Now, what I'm going to do, I need to call this function. So I'm just writing like on load is equal to. I'm just going to put some event over there, like when the page will get load, it will call this function. I'm calling this function over there. I need to call this b.html. So I'm just going to give the name b.html. See, at the time of load of the page, we are getting this message, thanks and welcome, want to save, enter your name. We are getting the name is like this. And finally, we are getting thanks and those. So what I'm trying to say, this is how we can apply the JavaScript. This is the normal process. And the better option is just write the functions over there and call the functions according to your requirement. So this is the normal way to write the JavaScript code. Save this. Save as. Again, I'm going to create like c.html. Now, what I'm going to do, suppose we are having some button. I'm just going to remove this events. Suppose we are having some button. I'm going to create a form. This is the form I'm going to create. In the form, I'm going to write input. Type is equal to type is equal to button. Input type is equal to button, and I'm just writing like ID is equal to btn1, and now I'm going to give the event like on click. So when we will click on the button, on click, it's going to call the form method over there like this A, and I'm going to put the value click me. Run this, and what functions we are having, it's a C. Just click on this and we are getting the message. All these things are there. So what I'm trying to say, this is how you can put the events over there. This is how we can put the event over there. It's clear? Now, suppose what I'm going to do, I'm just going to remove this. I'm just going to give the message. Okay. We are having some registration form, like implied registration form is there, like name. I'm going to use input type is equal to text, name is equal to t1, or in the place of name, I'm going to use the ID is equal to t1. It's the and value is equal to enter name. So this is the text box we are having. I'm going for the another text box. Like suppose I'm going to give salary. Input type is equal to text, ID is equal to T2, and value is equal to, I'm going to give like enter salary. Enter salary. Now, this is the button we are having. I'm just going to give the message like click me. So this is the button we are having. Now, if I'm going to run this, we are getting this like name and salary, and better, I'm just going to use the pre. Pre means what? This is what exactly the effect of the pre. So if you cannot apply the proper formatting over there, at least we need to go for the pre. So however, the things I'm going to arrange over there, it's going to display like this. So this is what exactly the impact of pre. So better if we are not going for the designs and multiple designs and all, if I'm not going to apply the div, I'm not going to apply the table, at least you should go for the pre. Now, what I'm looking for, like this is the form we are having. What I'm looking for, if I'm going to put the cursor over there, the text box should get blank. Like, yeah, it should be blank. So what we can go for, like I'm writing function B. This is the name of the function I'm going to use. And I'm just going to write, remember, in JavaScript, everything is the document. In JavaScript, everything is the documents. Like the complete page, entire page is the document. So I'm just going to write, this is called DOM model, document object model. I'm just going to use document. I'm just going to use document dot get element. Document dot get element by ID. This is the ID we are having. So I'm writing document dot get element by ID. I'm going to get that document, and I'm just going to give the ID like t1 dot value is equal to blank. Is equal to blank. And now what I need to do, I'm just going to call like on focus. On focus means when the cursor will be there. On focus, I'm going to call this function B. Run this. I'm just going to put the cursor over there. Yeah, it's a blank. It's a blank. But again, the same thing should be happen with the enter salary over there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the another function over there. Function C, and I'm going to write document.getElementById by t2.value is equal to null. And I'm going to call this function over there on focus C. I'm going to call this function. Run this. I'm going to put the cursor over there. Yeah, it's a blank. Again, I'm going to put the cursor over there. It's again blank. But what I'm looking for, like, okay, I'm going to put the cursor. But the thing is that if the cursor is there, at least I should enter some value over there. But if I'm going to make it blank, like I just leave it blank, there must be some proper message, like blank not allowed. Cursor should be there. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put like function b1, and I'm writing if document.getElementById of t1.value is equal to null, if the null will be there, then what I need to do, I'm just going to write alert blank not allowed, blank not allowed. At least there must be some message. So I'm just going to give blank. Remember, in JavaScript, semicolon is not required. And if you are going to give the semicolon, as such, it's not get the problem. It's not required. If I'm going to give this, again, it's not going to create any problem. Number one. Number two, in JavaScript, single quotation is also allowed. Double quotation is also allowed. So we don't need to get confused. I'm just going to write alert blank not allowed. And this particular function I need to call over here. So I'm just going to write on blur. On blur means when you are going to leave the focus. I'm writing on blur is equal to b1. I'm going to call this function. Run this. I'm going to put the cursor over here. See, I'm just going to leave it blank. We are getting the message blank not allowed. But the thing is that I'm getting the message blank not allowed. But cursor, again, cursor should be there in the, so we need to freeze the cursor. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write document.getElement of ID. It will display the message as well as I'm just going to give focus. Focus. Run this. The cursor is again, it's fixed over there. So we just, either we can go for the document. It's not required, like we can also go for this. This is the comment line. I'm just going to put the focus. Focus means what? If it's blank, yeah, it's blank. We cannot exit from the cursor, the text box. I need to put the values and after that I can exit from that. So this is how we can use the normal functions over there. The same thing we can apply with the text box too. But one problem is there. And what exactly the problem is, like this particular function, like function B and function C, both having the same purpose, But the problem is, like here we are using text box one, here we are using text box two. So in the place of these two functions, what we can do, we can create a single function with parameter. That will be better. So what I'm going to do, file save, save as, I'm going to create like d.html. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a function B. Function B. And this particular B function, I'm going to pass the parameter T. So T is the parameter. And I'm just going to leave this. We don't require the C function now. Now what I need to do, at the time of calling of the function, like on focus, I need to pass the ID of the text box. I'm just giving T1. And here I need to give the T2. So the single function will applicable for both the text box. So how it possible? Because we are passing the parameters over there. Run this. So this is the D we are having, d.html. And now if I'm going to, I'm going to make it blank. Again, I'm going to put the cursor over there. Yeah, again, it's blank. So the same thing we can achieve like this. So this is how you can pass the parameter. And at the time of calling of the function, you need to pass the parameters values over there. So this is how normally we can use the functions and all. Now, what I'm looking for, I want to apply the CSS. I want to apply the CSS over there. File, save as. I'm just going to create the e.html. So I want to apply the CSS over there. So how we can do that? I'm just going to remove this function. Unnecessary, it's going to create. I'm just going to remove that. So now what I'm looking for, I want to apply the CSS over there. So I'm writing a style, and I'm writing dot a. This a is what? It's a class I'm going to create, and I'm just going to give like background hyphen color. I'm just going to put like silver. I'm just going to give border dotted red 5pt. Again, I'm going to use dot b. I'm going to use dot b. Background color, I'm going to use white. And border, I'm going to give like solid, and I'm just going to make it blue 5pt. Now we are having the two class over there, and what I'm looking for, I want to apply these class. So what I'm looking for, when I will put the cursor, the focus will be there. The style of the text box get converted like this. If I'm going to leave the text box, the style of the text box like this. So I'm just going to write document.getElementById of t dot class name. I'm just going to use class name. And what will be the name of the class? It's A. And again, I'm going to create another function over there, like function C. And again, I'm going to write document.getElementById of t dot class name is equal to B. And I'm going to call this function. Input type is equal to text. On focus, I need to call the function B. And on blur, I need to call the function C. And I need to pass this parameter over there. The same function I need to call over here for the same effect. I'm going to give T2, and I'm going to give T2. Run this. It's e.html. I'm going to put the cursor over there. See, it's get change. And I'm going to put some values. It's get change. If I'm going to leave this, so accordingly you can get this. So this is how you can apply the style over there. So these are the basic things that always we need to remember. Now, file, save. This is how we can apply the style. Now, what I'm going to do, file, save as, f.html. Leave this. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a form, registration form, like it's a registration form, and I'm going to use like form action is equal to, I'm going to call some another function, another HTML file over there, a.html I'm going to call. It might be the PHP file or the JSP file or ASP file or the Django file. I'm just going to call the a.html action, and I'm writing method is equal to, either it will be get or post. And this is the text box we are having. It's a normal text box. Again, it's a text box we are having. Now, input type is equal to, I'm going to put like input type is equal to, I'm going to apply the submit. It's a submit button. And so this is the form we are having. This is the implied registration form we are having. Now, what I'm going to do, if I'm going to click on this submit button, it's going to call the a.html file. Even though you are not going to put the values over there, but if I'm going to click on the submit button, it's moving in the next page. So what we need to do, we need to validate this. Like if the text box is blank, the submit button has to stop for the next page. So what I need to do, like I'm just going to write a script and I'm going to create a function over there. Like function, what function I'm going to write? Suppose this is a validate function I'm going to create. Function validate. Now I'm writing if document, dot get element. Always we need to remember about the small and capital. It's going to follow the same specification, the same naming convention as it's in, as in Java. Get element by id. Like I'm going to give t1 dot value is equal to null. If it's going to be null, then what I need to do, I'm writing alert blank not allowed. And again, might be the second text box is blank. In that case, what will happen? I'm writing else if document.getElementById of t2 dot value is equal to null. Then again, I'm going to give the message like blank not allowed. But the problem is, and I'm going to call this function on the button click. This is the submit button. Remember, for normal button, we normally use on click, but for the submit, we need to use on submit means after clicking on the submit button, it's going to call what function? It's validate function it's going to call. So I'm writing on submit validate. Run this. And I'm going to click on the submit button. We are getting the message blank not allowed. Again, we are getting, but again, even though it's going to display the message blank not allowed, but again, it's redirecting for the a.html file. So what we need to do, again, we need to stop this redirecting. So how we can do this? So the important thing is, like always you need to use the return. Remember, in JavaScript, the function by default return the true. I'm going to return the false. Again, I'm going to return the false. Return false. Only return false is not sufficient. What we need to do, here we need to pass the like return keyword over there. I am writing return validate. So the return validate only work if this function is going to return true. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Like run this. Now, if I'm going to click on the submit button, we are getting the message blank not allowed. Again, it's not redirecting for the next page. If I'm going to give the values over there, yeah, no, it's fine. It's moving for the next page. So this is how we can validate the submit button. This is how we can put the validations for the submit button. The most important thing, we need to use the onSubmit event. And here the most important thing is we need to use the return. Like I'm writing return validate. And if I'm not going to put the return, there is no any impact of this return false. Remember one thing, like in JavaScript, by default, the function is going to return the null. Okay. One important thing I am also looking for, because we are having the salary field. So normally in the salary field, we should give the numbers over there. Like strings would not allowed. It's a normal process. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write, I'm going to check for the number also. I'm going to write else if. Document dot get element of t2 Now I am writing, we are having a function called is nan, not a number, is nan of document.write, document.getElementById of t2.value dot value is equal to true. It's going to true if we are going to enter the string. If I'm going to give the number, it's going to be false. So I'm writing else if is nan of document.getElementById of t2.value. So whatever the value as I'm going to give, whether it's a string or number, is equal to true. Again, I need to give the message a string not allowed. A string not allowed and return false. Run this. I'm going to give the value over there. And here I'm again going to give this string over there. I'm going to click this string not allowed. I'm going to give the number. Yeah, it's fine. Now it's redirecting for the next page. So each nan is the function, and that function will check whether we are inserting the string like alphabets or the number. Is not a number. Remember, this function is going to return true if I'm going to insert the string. If I'm going to insert the number, it's going to return the false. So we are having the is nan function over there. So this is how we can validate the submit button over there. This is again the important thing that always we need to remember. It's clear. Any questions from your side?
No questions.
Okay. Now, so these are the basic things that always we need to remember. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to remove this. I'm just going to use some button over there, form. I'm going to use the button over there like input type is equal to button, value is equal to click me, and I'm simply writing on click is equal to, I'm just going to call the function A. Sorry. And this is the function we are having. I'm just going to give the name of the function like A. Now, few important thing is there. How we can declare the, how we can use the array. Like in JavaScript, if I need to use the array, this is how we can do that. I'm writing where name is equal to new array. So at first I'm going to declare the array. Now what I need to do, I need to put some values over there. So I'm writing names of, in the place of name and all, I'm just going to use nm. I'm writing nm of 0 is equal to, I'm going to give Smith, like nm of 1 is equal to, I'm just going to give like Santos. Now, if I need to display this, I'm going to use for, or I'm simply going to use alert nm of 0 plus a space plus nm of 1. So my objective is just to familiar that like how we can create the array in JavaScript. So this is how we can create the array. Run this. What is the name of the function? It's g.html. Click on this and we are getting the message Smith and Santos. So this is how we can create the array in JavaScript. Other than this, the other option is we can also create the array like this. I'm going to use where nm1 is equal to new array, and in the single parenthesis, I'm going to give the value. I'm just going to give the value. This is how, again, we can put the array over there. This is how we can put the array over there. Now I'm going to write alert. I'm just going to use alert nm1 of 0, nm1 of 1 plus. So the thing is that like you need to be familiar with how we can create the array in JavaScript. It's a simple question. Normally they will ask you in the interviews and all. This is how we can use the array. It's clear how we can use the array. Okay. Now, the next thing is like, my question is like, what is the difference between equal to and triple equal to? We are having the double equal to and we are having the triple equal to. So the thing is that, what is the difference between that? Suppose I'm going to write a is equal to 90 and I'm going to write a is equal to 90. I'm just going to give alert a is equal to a. See what we are getting over there. Click on this. See, we are getting true. We are getting true because both the value is same. But if I'm going to write alert triple equal to a, run this. Click on this. See, the first time we are getting true, but the next time we are getting false. Why it is true? Oh, sorry. Better. Run this. First time we are getting true, but next time we are getting false. Remember, there is a difference between equal to and triple equal to. Equal to means what? It's an interview question, guaranteed interview questions for the JavaScripts in every programming language. Remember, it's check for equality. Check for equality. It's going to check for the equality. And this triple equal to is going for check for equality as well as type. It's also going to check the type. This is the difference that you need to remember. It's going to check for the equality as well as the type. So data type is different. It's a number, it's a string. So the data type is different. That's why we are getting false. So here we are getting false and here we are getting true. So this is the important thing that we need to remember, like what is the difference between equal to and triple equal to. Suppose, like now you are familiar with how we can get the value from the text box. Suppose we are having the checkbox input type is equal to checkbox. Input type is equal to checkbox, ID is equal to C1. And suppose I'm going to write like language and I'm going to use English. Now what I need to do, like if I'm going to run this, we are having the checkbox. I need to check whether the checkbox is checked or unchecked. It's a checked or unchecked. What is the status of this? Now what I need to do, I'm writing how we can display the values from this. I'm just writing alert document dot get element by id, and I need to check the id of, like the checkbox id for the checkbox is C1 dot checked. You need to use the keyword checked over there. Run this. If I'm going to click on this, see, we are getting true. Why true? Because it's checked. If I'm going to make uncheck, if I'm going to use uncheck over there, See, we are getting false. Why it's false? Because it's unchecked. So this is how you can get the value from the checkbox. If I need to check the value, we can use like this. Suppose we are having a submit button. Input type is equal to submit. Input type is equal to submit. We are having a submit button. Now what I'm writing, after submitting, I'm just going to use a.html file. Now my question is how we can submit a form using JavaScript. Like this is the submit button. When I will click on the submit button, it will go for the a.html file. Yeah, it's fine. But I'm not looking for that. What I'm looking for, I want to submit this button using the JavaScript. Like if I'm going to click on this submit click me button, it's going to call the event of the submit button. How we can do that? I'm just going to make these comments over there. Now what I'm going to write, I'm just going to write document dot get element by ID, or I'm just going to use document dot I'm going to use forms. Forms of what? Zero. Because we are having the single form, I'm writing form of zero. Dot submit. And run this. I'm going to click on click me button. By default, the click me event is going to call the submit button, and submit button is working on this. So this is the good questions for the interviews. Like in the interview, they will ask you the question, how we can call the submit button using JavaScript. This is how we can do this. How we can call the submit button using JavaScript. So these are the important thing always we need to remember. File, save. Yeah, it's clear. Okay.
Yeah, it's clear. I have a question though. Does that override like the else if statements if anything is blank?
Pardon?
Like the you know how like earlier you had like else if blank. If you put the document.forms.submit, does that override it, or do you still have to make sure it's not blank?
I'm not reading your question. Once again, repeat that.
If you have a code in there that says that the document cannot be blank.
Listen. If the code is there, you are talking about this code.
Well, I'm not talking about that code. I'm just saying, like, if you had a code in there saying that the document cannot be blank, and you're putting, you're submitting that using JavaScript, does that submit override it? Am I clear?
See, basically on the submit button, only one events will be there. Like on this submit particular submit button, we are having the events like x and a.html. So after clicking on the submit button, it will go for the a.html file.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the event we are working for.
Yeah, I know that. What I'm saying is if you have a code, like let's say you have a field, a name field in your form, right, that you're submitting.
Mm-hmm.
And the name is blank, and you already have some code saying that the name field cannot be blank.
Naturally it will validate that. Okay. Naturally, yeah. The behavior of the function, like behavior of calling this event, will be the same like you are clicking on the submit button.
Okay, so it won't. You still have to make sure it's not blank.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. It's basically nothing. It's just how to call the submit button without clicking on the submit button. Yeah. Okay. That's good. Okay.
So in this case, like maybe we can like Like we are having the submit button over there. So you said like how to call a submit button without clicking on it.
Exactly.
So in this way, maybe we can hide the submit button too, because it's making it confusing,
exactly.
Right?
Yeah, exactly. We can do that.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah, that's, we can do that. Okay. Now what we need to do, okay. Suppose I'm going to write document.write. I'm going to write alert, and I'm going to write isNan of Santos. What will be the return? What will be the result of this? What will be the result of this?
It will be true.
Yeah, exactly true. Why true? Because it's a string.
You get not a number. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Suppose I'm going to write alert, and I'm going to write isNan of. I'm going to give the date like this. Run this. What will be the answer of this?
I think it should be also true because we pass it as a string.
So first is true and the second is also the true. Yeah, because we are using a string double quotations over there.
Yeah. So I have one more question. Like calling the form like document or form, you use the, like the index, because right now we having only one form.
Exactly.
If we have like more than one form, like
again,
then we can
use
ID.
Even we can also use document dot. Suppose the name of the form is FRM1. We can use document dot FRM1 dot submit.
Okay, so we have to give the name to the form.
Yeah, yeah. Otherwise, we can also use the index.
Okay.
So that means we'll have to provide an ID for the form, right?
It's a name.
Name.
Like here we are using isNan of. Okay, suppose I'm going to give like this. What will be the result of this?
It should false, I think.
True, false. Because it's a number.
Yeah.
Okay. Suppose I'm going to write alert of, I'm going to make it comment. These are the small questions. It's a written test question they will ask you in the written test. Like suppose I'm going to give 1 + 2 + 4. What will be the output of this? I'm just going to write alert 1 + 2 + 4. What will be the output of this?
16.
So what will be the result?
1, 2.
Yeah, I'm going with 16.
1, 2, 4.
1, 2, 4. Yeah.
Because the first is the string, so it's string. Going to calculate as a string. Okay. What will be the output of this? What will be the output of this?
34.
Yeah, 3, 4.
3, 4. First one is 1, 2, 4. Third one is 3, 4.
So for isNan, if it's in quotes, then it doesn't matter. It'll always be in.
It's a string. Yeah, exactly. Suppose what I need to do, like suppose we are having a text box. I'm writing input. Type is equal to text. name is equal to t1, or I'm going to use the id is equal to t1. Now what I need to do, what I'm looking for, like I want to increase the font size for this text box. Using JavaScript, I want to do that. I want to increase the font size for this text box. So how we can do this? Like I want to give the font size. So what we need to use, we just need to write document dot get element by id of document dot get element by id of t1.
Yeah.
No, it's not necessary that you need to define this style and all. What we can do, we can give this style over there also. I'm just writing dot style dot font size. And I'm just going to give like font size equal to 15. Like I'm going to give this, I'm going to click on this. Font size get increased for this. I'm going to give like 30. Run this. I'm going to click on this button. Yeah, it's get increased.
Yeah.
So this is how you can put the style. All the parameters you can put over here. Otherwise, we can also use the class name that we can do. Now, these are the small things. Always you need to prepare for this. Like these are the small things they will ask you in the interviews. Now, the next question is how we can use object in JavaScript. How we can use like object in the JavaScript. Like we are having the concept of class and object. Anyone can ask you the question, can we apply the OOPS concept in JavaScript? Yes, we can do that. So how we can create the object? So this is how we can create the object. Like where I'm writing a student is equal to new object. We need to use the keyword object over there. We need to use the keyword object over there. Now I'm writing a student dot name is equal to like Hermit. I'm just going to give like a student dot location is equal to like USA. And again, I'm going to write like alert a student dot name plus a student dot location I'm going to give. Run this. I'm going to click on this. See, I'm getting the message Hermin in USA. So the important thing is how we can create the object in JavaScript. So this is how you can create the object in JavaScript. No. Now my question is like we are having the object. What I need to do? How to add functions in object. Like we are having the class, within the class normally we are having the attributes. These are the attribute of the class. Suppose I want to create a function for this, then how we can do this? I'm just writing like I'm going to create the function for this. My object is a student, so I'm writing a student dot, and I'm just going to give the name. Remember, normally here we create the function that will work like a property. I'm just going to use like function get name. I'm using function keyword over there. Function keyword over there. And what it's going to return? Return student dot name. So when I will call this function, it's going to return the name. Now what I'm going to write. Like I'm going to write alert student dot get name. I'm just going to use alert student dot get name. So when I will use this get name, it's going to return the name and it's going to return a student name. So this is how we can use this. Click on this. I'm writing get name. We are getting Hermin. So this is how you can create the object, and someone is going to ask you like how we can create the function. that should return like some values over there. So how we can get the function? So this is how you can add the functions with the JavaScript, like the class. Okay. Now, suppose I'm going to write I'm going to make it comment. No, what I'm looking for. Suppose I'm going to write where my string is equal to new string. And in the new string, I'm going to give the mail. This is what? It's an object, remember, because we are using the new keyword over there. Now I'm going to use where my string two is equal to, I'm going to give the mail. What is the difference in that? It's a normal variable of a string type. Now, if I'm going to use alert, how we can confirm like it's a variable or it's a string, like it's an object. I'm writing alert my string dot constructor plus I am writing my string 2 dot constructor. This is the typical interview questions for the JavaScript constructor. And run this. Click on this. See, function, a string, native code. My string dot constructor, my string two dot constructor. Remember one thing, like this is the object, and we are using this object like of this type, and this is again the variable, but again this variable is of type string type. Remember one thing, like if I'm going to create the variables and if I'm going to create the object like this, both is going to return the string constructor by default. See, both are going to return the string constructor by default. So what I'm trying to say, like both are having the same thing, like because yeah, we are using string, new string over there, or we are simply putting the values over there. Internally, they are going to call the string functions, like a string constructor.
It's in the same.
Yeah, it's the same.
It's like in Java, yeah.
Yeah, it's the same thing. Now, one important thing, like we are having, okay. Suppose we are having where a is equal to, I'm going to use Santosh. It's a simple variable we are having. What I'm going to do, I'm writing where b is equal to a. So b will contain the value of a, and And now what I'm going to do, I'm writing a is equal to null. I'm writing a is equal to null. Now I'm going to print. I'm going to print a plus a space plus b. So what will be the output? What will be the output?
A, B, right?
Oh. No. A having Santosh.
Santosh, well, Santosh.
B having the value of A. Now I'm going to give the A is equal to null.
Santosh.
I think it's null for all.
Oh, it's null. There's a null.
Only Santosh, maybe.
What is this?
It's printing, I think. We put it in the print.
Oh. Python.
JavaScript, yeah.
See. Mm-hmm. Null and Santosh. Remember, when we use a is equal to null and we are giving a plus b, so B is going to make the copy of this. So this new value will be there. That's why we are getting null and Santosh. Remember this. Suppose I'm going to use where. Suppose I'm going to write like price 1 is equal to 10. Okay. I'm writing where price 2 is equal to 20, or second 10. And I'm writing where price 3 is equal to, and I'm going to give like new number, and I'm going to give the value like 10. Now I'm writing print.
No print.
Alert price 1 equal to price 2. What will be the output of this? And I am writing true. Alert price 1 is equal to price 3.
I think it should be 2 for the both.
True and false.
I think true for both. I don't know. Let's see.
See, for the first it's true, but for the second it's false. For the first it's true because the type is also the same and the value is also the same. But here,
I was thinking like it's also number.
Price and no, but the thing is
it's
that
not it's integer, an, not
it's
integer.
A, yeah, it's an object.
Yeah,
it's an object and it's a normal primitive data types.
Yeah.
That's why. Suppose I'm going to use where object 1 is equal to, and I'm going to give some value like a colon Santosh. Okay, and I'm going to use where object 2 is equal to, again the a is equal to Santosh. Now I'm going to write alert object 1 is equal to object 2. What will be the output of this?
Should be true.
Run this.
They look same.
Click on this. We are getting false. Why we are getting false? Both can't be different. Both are the object. Both are the object. That's why both can't be the same. And that's why we are getting false. because we are
so
using,
but like, you assign the object one to object two, that will be true, right?
Yeah, no, no, object one, yeah, object one.
If you assign the object one to object two, that will be true, right?
We are getting false. We cannot assign object to object.
Oh.
I'm just going to make it comment. You don't need to do anything before any interview. What you need to do, you just need to go through this file. Believe me, at least two or three questions will be there from this. I'm just writing. Alert. Number of. Hi. I'm writing. Alert. Number of null. I'm writing alert. Number of this one. I'm writing alert. Number of true. And I am writing alert number of NaN. First of all, what will be the output of this? Run this. Click on this. For first, we are getting NaN. Not a number.
Not a number.
Yeah, but we are getting the message. We are not getting the error. Yeah, for the second, we are getting the zero. For the second, we are getting the zero, even though there is the null. For the third, we are getting the same value. It's perfectly fine. Yeah, because it's a true. That's why we are getting one. And for this NaN, again, we are getting NaN. So you need to remember this. Unexpected behavior. I'm going to convert the string into the number. We are getting NaN. I'm going to convert the null into the number. We are getting one. I'm getting to convert true into the number. We are getting one. I'm going to convert the NaN into the number one. We are getting NaN. So you need to remember this. Okay. This is the unexpected behavior that you need to remember. Normally, if I'm going to ask you, like, what will be the output, you will say, like, it's true and false. But it's not going to return the true and false. Suppose I'm going to use, like, where a is equal to. I'm going to give like this. I'm going to use where b is equal to a multiplied by 5, a multiplied by 4. And I'm going to give where c is equal to plus a. Now I'm writing alert. We can use type of a. So what will be the type of a? What will be the type of b? What will be the type of c?
String.
Oh. Yeah, for this
string.
String.
Okay, for this
string.
String.
And for this
number. How do you call it in
it Japan? Should be string, but we have not
the first given one is, the first thing. One is a string, but the next will be the number.
Oh,
because if
why
you are
number
going to, yeah, because you are going to put the manipulations over there, so implicitly it's going to convert that. That's why it's a number.
It's different from Python. Yeah,
it's so
I'm thinking about Python.
See, that's why I'm going to cover this, because I know these are the area normally it's get the problem for every programmer, like for the every interviewer. Like normally people go from with the preparation with Java, preparation of the Pythons and all. But normally people avoid this JavaScript. Believe me, because in the web technology, we need to learn the JavaScript properly. So these are the important things. That's why for every interview, you need to go with these questions and answer. Clear?
So number, we are using like the number function. So the number is a data type?
Yeah, this number, it's a function. It's going to convert this into the number. Conversion function.
Okay, it will convert it into the integer, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So a lot of things are there. You just need to focus on this. Initially, the basics are there. And other than the basic, this is totally important one. And better option will be take the printout of this. Like here, the better option will be write the answer. And before any interview, go and prepare this. Believe me, in the written test, these questions will be there and you need to give the answer. Other than this, few things are remaining. I will cover that if I will get the extra time. Oh, like after 25th again, I don't need to start with new topics and all. So in the meantime, if you people will be there, I will cover this also. It's fine?
Yeah.